Hey guys, I'm back with Layers of Fear. This is part 3. We're gonna be starting where we left off with the flamingos. I don't really know what to say. I mean, okay, I have a theory. He killed his wife and is using her as canvas because the, That's pretty good evidence. So I think every time we paint, we get something new. So we have a patch of skin, the creepy hallway with the book on the floor. Oh, okay. Now we have an elevator. How big is this fucking house? I know he's like going insane, but I mean, still. Oh, I guess we can only go up. Damn, this is shaky. Damn, that's some thick layers of brick. What the fuck? No, what did that say? Okay, at least we didn't stop on that first floor. That was fucking demented. Okay. Open up. Locked. Is there a key? I'm really scared. Locked. Locked. How come all my fucking rooms are locked in my own damn house? Locked. Oh, that's open. Fuck you. Fucking creepy baby. Close that. Okay, well, hey, a key. Okay. Letter. Dear sir, while I can creatively understand that you are upset and I have nothing but sympathy for you, for your wife and yourself, I must big word state that I do not wish to receive any further big word for you in this matter. Any skin graft proceed is extremely complicated and healthy, especially with the risk of failure. Having started that, I have stated that I assure you that me and my colleagues at St. Anne have made every effort to ensure a positive outcome for your wife. Professionally speaking, I believe we have done the best job possible considering that extent of tissue damage. You are, of course, entitled to your opinion, and I certainly understand your disappointment. What I do not understand is how you seem to think writing hateful letters to me or my fellow doctors will empeorate the situation. As I've already stated, I can certainly understand you've been under a lot of stress as of late, and thus I will not press charges if you refrain from any further. Let me make it absolutely clear that I will not tolerate any further threats aimed at my staff and aimed at my staff, my family, or myself. If you wish to seek psychological help, I can have an associate with regards William H. Green Medicine. Okay. Okay, fuck that creepy painting again. The fuck? Okay then. I get chills down my back.
Okay. Why'd you stop? That tune was perfect. Honey, please, just a little longer. At least until I finish painting this one part. Oh, don't make me beg.
Oh shit, that's his wife. fuck? Looks like there's supposed to be a head there. I don't fucking know anymore. This game is really fucking creeping me out. Okay, locked. Can't use the key on that fucking door? Fuck that. Okay, so the elevator's broken. Knock, knock, housekeeping. Let me change. No? Okay then. What's in here? Lock. Fucking course. Oh hey, that kinda looks like the Hobbit. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Who started a fire up here? Jessica! God damn it, Jessica. What are you doing with my stuff? Starting fires, of fucking course. Oh wow. The one time I'm like, oh, the floor's gonna drop. It's not gonna drop. Man, my limp gets really bad when I move fast. Jessica! Where are you? Can't be starting fires in my fucking house. Oh! Fuck you. Fuck. Fucking babies. I've been here. I hear a rat, motherfucker. Oh. Let me just turn this light on. Make up your mind. Making up my mind that I'm not going in there. Okay, it looks like I got one place I have to go, but you know. Let's just try this. Nope. Okay. Through the creepiest door. Oh, wait, no. See? We could go through here. Or not. God damn it. Okay, light on now. Light switch. That's fucking creepy and the shadows are wrong. Fuck you, that deer. Light. Turn on. What the fuck? Turn on. There. On. This is creepy. What the actual fuck? What is that? This guy's actually fucking mental. That's a lot of metals. Ooh, hey. That looks like something. Bad won't let us see. Okay. Do I leave? I don't know. I feel like this room is too big for there nothing to be. Guess I just leave. Okay. Oh my god. Fuck, I don't know. Fuck you. That's what. Scary shit. We have to find a code. Okay, this room looks nice and peaceful. thought I was going to turn around and that was going to be the same room. It can't be undone. Oh, okay. The fuck? Looks like there's gas down there. Okay. The fuck? Shut up! Shut up! Fuck. I said shut up and I die! No! The fuck? Oh, the wheelchair, because I had to amputate my leg. Hold on. Oh, it says something. You want this as a lead? I don't know. What the fuck? What the fuck? God, it's bloody or painty. I don't know, but fuck. I was gonna close that anyways. What's up, George Washington? Yeah, nothing. Okay. Yeah, this room seems dangerous enough, so nope. Okay, then. Let's try this room. Nope. Okay. Creepy door at the end of the hallway. That's always it. Because fuck me. What the fuck? And hold on. What the fuck? Painting! Fuck. Okay, so. Fuck. See? I have rats. Oh, fuck it. I ain't going back. Whew. Oh, fuck. Light on. Light on. Go. Turn on. What the fuck? Oh, goddamn. Fuck. Locked. Seems normal enough for now. A panda? What the fuck is up with pandas? Wine, of course. The letter. Let me read the letter. Well, let me read the letter. Fuck that. Fuck that letter. Oh, hey, a key. Oh, fuck. Let's just come back on. Fuck. What the fuck? Someone's knocking. Someone's knocking. What the fuck? What the fuck? Ah! It's my cane.
This house is absolutely amazing. But those stairs. With that leg of mine, I think you'll have to carry me to the bedroom once we move in.
Fuck that. Okay. So what's gonna happen? Huh. Like a destroyed church. My bedroom. You moved. Still nothing in the mirror. The wood's kind of wobbly. Oh. No, let's go back to normal. What the fuck?
I needed a jar and a plastic tubing. I siphoned gas before. I knew how it was done.
What?
I stuck the tube in a vein and sucked on it until blood filled.
What the fuck?
Then put the tube in the jar and it just kept coming. A taste of copper haunted me the entire night. Why didn't I think of a syringe?
What the actual fuck? Oh, that makes me sick a little bit. Do we have to... put everything back to normal? So confused on what do I have to do now. Okay, so am I done with this? I don't know. Just want to leave. I see something out there. Well, not really, but I mean, come on. What do you want me to do? What the fuck? My grandmother has one of these. Yes, it's going back to normal. Okay, but there's still blood. Time to get the fuck out. Okay. Thank fucking God. Any notes? For me this time? Oh, yeah. Hate even now. Lost alone. You deserve it. I gave for you. Finish it. Okay. More notes. I can't stand seeing you like this. You're not well. You were stewing and shaking all night. And there you are, locked in your workshop as usual. This whole tortured artist nonsense has got to stop. Okay. Looks like I haven't found anything new, per se. April 6th, as one of my friends wanted to point out, that is their birthday. Whoop-de-fucking-do. I'm just kidding. They're probably going to watch this and think, wow, thanks. What else is there? Okay, June 6th, he's on about the damn rats again. I don't think I've seen one, but that doesn't stop him from lying out traps all over the place. He claims he can hear them in the walls and that there must be hundreds of them. God, I fucking hope it's true. I hope they're crawling out at night and eating you in your sleep. You're cruel, self-obsessed, pathetic, drunk. Okay, thanks. July 19th. Judging by the silence that has now fallen over the house, I can safely assume that he has finally passed out. Undoubtedly surrounded by empty bottles and throttled pieces of canvases that have become his preferred bedflows. Every time it happens, I pray it will be the last time. I pray. I don't know those two words. Our Lord in heaven, let him crack his head open and rot, spew out. Let him cut his wrist on the glass and the red blow flow. Let him choke on his own vomit so that we may all find peace. For if you don't, one day I will find the courage to walk down the steps and end him myself. You of all should know this. It's not the lack of will that stays my head. That stays my hand. Amen. So this bitch is considering killing her husband? I can't say anything because I'm pretty sure the husband killed his wife. Okay. Time to add to my flamingos. Okay, they don't look like flamingos much anymore. I don't know what the fuck that is. Looks like a bloody tree. I can't move. Okay. Oh, what's the message? From Embergers. I don't know what that fucking says. But that is the end of episode 3. Thank you. So we have our wife's skin and blood. I feel like we're going to have hair, nails, and teeth and eyes down here. I don't fucking know. But that's the end of episode 3. I'll come back with episode 4 sometime soon. But this shit's getting really creepy. So, talk to you guys later. Don't forget to like.